Okay, it's time for Westworld. I have my Westworld music printed out, okay? I hope you do too. If you don't, that is A-okay. I will make sure to drop a link in the description of this video so you can purchase your music, okay? But before we get started on our Westworld, just a few housekeeping items. If you don't mind sharing this video, that would be really helpful because every share reaches a new group of people that may not even know that I'm doing these lessons for free. So every single share is very helpful for me. The second thing is if you can subscribe on YouTube, that would be awesome too. I have so many new students joining me from YouTube, so that is a really cool thing. Just search for Izzy Chia and you can hit that subscribe button. The third thing is please join my private piano lesson group. It is called Encore Music Makers. And that is where you get one-on-one feedback from me. If you're encountering some difficulty in your piano songs, you can always record videos of yourself playing and I will help you as best as I can, okay? We have a community, I think, of about 175 students now. So, awesome. and then the last thing, of course, like I mentioned before, if you still need the music for your Westworld theme song, I will have the link available in the comments and in the description. All right, let's get started. Okay, so of course I have my file folder. I print out my music all the time and I tape it inside of these file folders. That way it makes it easier to see all the stuff that we're working on. You see? 3 pages. And last week was our first lesson on Westworld. So a quick review of what we had learned. We had focused on measures 1 through 13, which was pretty much page 1, okay? Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Yes, all of page 1 was what we worked on, okay? Reminder also that this song is in A minor, okay? So if you need a quick review of A minor, go ahead and play an A minor scale, right? A minor. And I did a harmonic minor scale. Just play through your scales, some arpeggios, and some chords just to get you in the mindset of A minor, okay? Now, as we were learning this, we had a whole section here of octaves in the left hand. So it was very much an exercise in hand stretching. So if you can reach octaves, then you're really getting yourself a good workout there, okay? So I'm just gonna see how it goes, you know. I'm gonna play through it one time and we will see what it sounds like. All right. Okay. So we are starting on the super duper low A. All right. And I'm starting on A over here in the right hand as well. Remember, it's that weird 12-8 time, but that's okay. We don't have to worry about that. All right. One, two, ready, play. first page, okay? First page of Westworld. I did okay. I think the very last section, I missed that interval of a third, a fourth, going back up to a G in my left hand. But that's okay. It just shows I need to practice a little more. but that's all right. So now that we're sort of in this second section of Westworld, that's where the momentum building is happening, right? We know if you are a fan of the show, this is about the time where the scene cuts in the introduction to the humanoid robot human playing the piano, right? And it shows that. So in order for it to really keep that momentum building, let's see if we can learn the second page, and we're going to go all the way to the last line, and we're going to stop at the measure, the first measure of the last line, okay, where it switches and it has like the E. We're going to stop right before that, okay? All right? Let's see how it goes, all right? Okay, so it's starting here on an A, okay? I'm going to start with my right hand only, okay? Because I really don't know what to expect as far as rhythm and notes are concerned. We're starting here at an A, but then it has you going down into the bass clef and playing a C, B, G sharp, A, right? So you have that we need to write in. Okay, that's measure 17. I want you to take your pencil and write a 17 with a circle around it, okay? I'm gonna tell you why in just a second, all right? Because we're gonna be referencing that section quite a bit. You see that 17 I wrote? Do the same thing in your music, okay? All right. So starting there, the first 16th note is actually going to be played by the left hand, so I'm going to sort of ignore it for right now. But the second note in that little melodic pattern, the first note in the right hand, it has like three ledger lines, and then it's the note right below the third ledger line. That is going to be a bass clef E, okay? But you're playing it with your right hand, okay? So we're talking about this E. Okay, go ahead and put your thumb, finger one, on that. So you have E, then it stretches up to a B flat. It's like a tritone. So E, B flat, and then C, and then D. Okay, I'm using fingers one, two, three, four. Okay, so you can write that up there too. One, two, three, four. B flat, C, D. Okay? Right? Now the next one looks similar. You're still playing that first right hand note as an E, bass clef E, okay? And then the next one is actually going to be an A natural, okay? Sounds weird. You go from a tritone to a fourth, okay? So E, A, and then the next note is a B flat and C. Same fingers, one, two, three, four. Sounds different. Yeah. So the first one is like this. Second. We move on to the third pattern. The third one is still your low E, but then you're going to turn your A to a flat. Okay. The next note is a B flat. C. Okay. is E, G, A flat, B flat. Okay? Still a 1, 2, 3, 4, okay? I know, it's not that fun. All right, so that section, measure 17, the one that I had you draw a circle around. Let's see if we can play just the right hand, and I'll snap every time the left hand note is supposed to come in, okay? We're not worrying about the left hand right now. Just the right hand, all right? I have my right hand thumb on E in the bass clef, and then my finger 2 is on a B flat to start, okay? I'm going to count. 1, 2, ready, play. See, I already messed up. This is hard. Let's try it again. 1 and 2 and ready and a play and a. There it is. All right, let me go to piano view so you can see this. It's tricky, but we're gonna get it, okay? Starting at measure 17, this is line 2, second measure of the second page of my Westworld theme song, okay? I'm snapping on the left hand note because we haven't learned the left hand yet, and we're only going over the right hand notes, okay? Let's count off. 1, 2, ready, play. Brackets around that section, I highly encourage you to do so because that's going to be a point of drilling. Okay? All right. Now let's move on for the right hand. Okay? Looking at line 3, this is where it gets a little bit hairy. We are using all 5 fingers of the right hand, and you're going to have to be able to move your wrist with the movement of the phrases. Okay? Let's start. We're starting here with an A. Okay, A, C, E, G sharp, A. Okay, let's see what it looks like in piano view. A, C, E, G sharp, A. A, C, E, G sharp, A. You see how my wrist is moving? In the same spot, I guarantee you I would give myself a hand cramp trying to play that phrase, right? And see, look at that stretch between 3 and 4. That's painful. So I use the range of motion of my wrist to be able to play that phrase effectively and without injuring myself, okay? So at part 3, you play that flourish or that melodic line, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 times. there are a little bit of tied notes and other things that we have to hold at certain points. But at this point, I really want you to be able to get that range of motion in your wrist, okay? I'm gonna play through that, all right? Starting at part 3, measure 18. 1, 2, ready, play. Right. I probably played that way too many times, but that is okay. I was just really trying to focus on the way my hand and my wrist were moving, okay? As you're going through it and you've gotten the pattern down in your fingers, then you can start to really focus on the extra ties in here. We have a tied note A in the second measure of part 3, and that happens 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 times in a row, right? So it would sound a little bit different. The beat would start on the C instead of the A. 1, 2, 1, 2. 1, 2. Very, very good. All right. I know that that was probably really complicated, but that's okay. All right. If you have your note names written and you have all of your fingers nice and limber, you're going to be able to play these phrases with a little bit more ease than if you were to just try to dive into the song, right? We have to break it down sometimes. It's not going to be easy from the very get-go all the time. It's just not, which is why I do these lessons, these Learn With Me lessons. I'm learning it just along with you, so I'm going to make mistakes, okay? All right, now that we have gone over the right-hand section, let's see if we can move over to the left-hand now, okay? Starting at the top of page 2, I notice we have that A, right? And that repeating pattern. It's sort of like that mechanical heartbeat or the hum of the fan inside of a computer, right? It just keeps going constant, constant, constant through the whole thing, right? We start there with the A, it repeats. Then it goes to a B, right? And then down to a C. Now, when we get to that big, scary measure 17, let's talk about those left-hand notes that are sort of the beat of measure 17. The first one is a B-flat, so go ahead and write down a B-flat. Then we have an A natural, A-flat, and then we end on the G of measure 17, okay? Now, when we begin part 3, we have the A again, right? And that's constant, constant, A, A, A. When we get to the second measure there, it goes down to an F with that constant group of three eighth notes, right? It's kind of like a triplet, right? And then back at measure 20, we have the A again, okay? And that's going to end the section that we were learning for today, okay? Now, we have to play this now. All right, shake it up. Woo, let's get it. All right, so top of page 2, we're starting with the low A. All right, I'm going to switch to piano view so we can learn this together. All right, page 2, that's measure 14. I'm going to count off and we're going to just attempt the left hand, okay? 1, 2, ready, play. Wait, that's not a B. That's not a B at all. That's an F. Why did I write B? Okay, scratch that. So we're going over here again. A. That is not an A. Oh, yes, it is an A. A. And then we have F. My goodness gracious. Okay. So let me show you what I did. Let me switch here. This is an F. It's not a B. I don't know why I said a B. You see that F right there? Top of page 2, second measure. That's an F. My mistake. All right. Let's try this again. Scratch that. All right. Starting here with the low A. I'm going to count off again. 1, 2, ready, play. Sounded like a whole bunch of notes, but that's okay. All right, I want you to notice something. At part 3, this is where the momentum is really building, right? Part 3, you notice that the left hand, instead of having your left hand pinky being held down for a dotted half note, now it has turned into playing the actual big beat. It's turned into a dotted quarter instead, okay? you notice it happens four times in each measure, okay? That is different. If you look at part two, that's where they're playing the left hand with the dotted half note as the pinky instead. So it has switched. It has gotten more, it's gotten to be, they've divided the beats even more, which means that the intensity is building, okay? Keep that in mind as you're practicing, okay? Now, page two, let's extract that measure 17, okay? We need to extract it because, like I said, it's a tricky measure, but it's one of those that, like, you're left completely open in the air, and you have to get those notes right, or it sounds like you're not even doing a good job. So, let's see if we can get those notes right at measure 17, okay? Remember, we're traveling down by half steps in the left hand, and we have this really strange pattern in the right hand, okay? Let me switch to piano view, and we'll see if we can get through it, okay? Note by note, all right? I'm gonna count off very slowly, all right? One, two, ready, play. Measure 17, like I said, make sure you extract it, okay? Drill it like five or six times until you're really, really confident with it, all right? So I'm gonna put 5x because I wanna play it through five times as I practice for this week, okay? That is a really tough section, all right? I'm not nervous about it though because I know it's just gonna take time, it's just gonna take practice, okay? As we work through this section, it's going to be important for us to really sort of emulate what that introductory music is like. So if you need to go back and like watch the intro to Westworld, the show, I would do that, okay? Because then you get a really good sense of the style that the composer is trying to convey in the music, okay? It's never a bad idea to listen to it, right? And keep that in mind as you're practicing too. Even if you're taking it super, super slowly, you can still convey style, okay? That includes things like accent marks, that includes things like dynamics, okay? And intensity, right? So, very, very great job today for our lesson. I'm very happy that we're really tackling such a tricky song. It's difficult. It's not an easy song at all. So keep up the practice. Keep up your good work. Remember, if you've got any questions about any specific sections or measures of music or exercises or fingering suggestions, hop into the private group, okay? And ask your question. Never ever worry about asking questions. That's what I'm here to help you do is learn piano, right? So we can work on it together and I can give you some tips. All right, I'm gonna close my music. All right, great job on Westworld today. Quick reminder, I am a donation-based studio. So what does that mean? That means that I am a tuition-free studio. So if you're watching me on YouTube, these are free, right? Same thing on Facebook. These are free lessons. But if you happened to have room in your budget to help support me, I would really appreciate it because I have lost my income due to this coronavirus. So I'm trying to make these interactive lessons as accessible as possible. So if you want to join me on Patreon, that's probably the easiest way to automate a donation to me. I have tiers as low as $5 a month and all the way high as $50 a month. So just pick something that is comfortable to you. It's an automatic payment every first of the month. It sends me a little bit of money, and it just helps pay my bills and, you know, pay for this internet that I have to use and for equipment and all kinds of stuff, okay? So I appreciate that. Go visit patreon.com/izzychia, okay? All right, and of course, every lesson we end with a music quote, right? And today's music quote comes from the, jazz singer and pianist, Harry Connick Jr. And this is what he says. I am able to sometimes express things even more articulately on the piano than I am with singing. That's interesting, isn't it? You know, sometimes musicians, like, especially singers and pianists, if they can do both, sometimes they feel like they can really express themselves better without singing. Like sitting at the piano bench and playing something really heartfelt and really moving. So that's just a testament to how awesome this instrument is and how lucky we all are to be able to learn how to play it, right? So think about that. Thanks for joining me today for our Learn With Me lessons. I'm happy you could join me. Like I said, share this video, subscribe on YouTube. I'll see you in the private group, and I'll see you next week for piano, okay? Take care, everybody. Bye.